You've been fooled before. You could be fooled again.
Being tested.
You don't know. It's just their game for you.
You never know which way it's going to go.
I want to tell you a story about a god of the Northmen called Baldur. The second son of Odin, he was beautiful, good, and wise. He was fair of feature, he spoke fair words, he gave fair judgments. Light shone from him. Only good things were told of him. Yet he was the first of the gods to die. The Northmen tell this story about the death of Baldur. It begins with dark dreams. Night after night, Baldur dreams of his own death, and the gods fear for his life. So Baldur's mother makes everything in the world fire, water, iron, stone, earth, wood.
He's waiting for you. He's close. Go through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it. What's behind the gate?
Where will it take you?
It's not safe. Dillian.
There he is.
There he is.
What are you waiting for?
Quick, find a way.
Find him.
Go through him
before he disappears.
Dillian.
Where is he?
Where's he gone?
We're in the wrong world.
He's not here.
She's in the wrong world.
He's not in this world.
He's in the other one.
He's in the other one.
He's in the dark world.
The world once seemed so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillian taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching away from the gloom. And Senno explored new paths into the unknown.
Himself into a woman and asks Baldur's mother, is it really true that all things promise to keep him safe? I did not ask the mistletoe, Baldur's mother confesses. I thought it was too young. Oh dear.
Why isn't he here?
He's gone.
He's in the dark world.
He's gone to the dark world.
You're Dillion in the wrong
saved
world.
You from there. He's in the other world.
The dark world.
Without you.
She thought that she knew best.
She thought she had light within her.
She is pure darkness. You have no chance for love.
Nobody will love you again.
Ever. Ever again.
You can.
Goes to the gods as they throw things at Balder. The blind god, Hoth, was there. Loki asks him why he wasn't taking part. Hoth says, I cannot see where Balder stands, and even if I could see him, I have no weapon. Loki replies, here is a wand. I will tell you where he stands. And Hoth throws the mistletoe at Balder. It pierces through him, and to everyone's horror, Balder is killed. And for this, Hoth is slain.
Years had passed since she left her father. She trained hard alongside her friend, Dillion. She saw things no one else could. Patterns, shapes, movement. An intuition that made her an exceptional warrior. Friendship turned to love. But the shadow of darkness never let her go, and she was caught between two worlds. That of Zinbel and her past, and Dillion, her future. Two realities tearing at her soul.
So, the gods cannot be saved instead.
The curse cannot be
removed. Was it worth it? You're still alive.
You have no time for this. Speed up.
These traps mean nothing. It's all part of their game.
Trials to distract you.
They've set you up, and now they're going to watch you for.
What if these trials mean nothing?
Laughing at you.
You killed him with your love because he believed in you.
Dillion, you're letting this get in the way.
What if they are just to tire you out, make you weak before the battle?
Overcome with grief, the gods send Hermod to ride to Hel and ask Hela to let Balder return home. All the gods are weeping, he says. Are they? Asks Hela. We shall see if he is honest. If everything in the world will weep for him, he shall go back to the gods. But if even one thing refuses, Balder stays with me. The gods send messengers everywhere. Weep for Balder. Weep him out of hell. And everything wept. Men, beasts, earth, stone, trees, metal, everything, except for a giantess they find in a cave. Balder was never my friend, she says. Let Hel keep what she has. The Northmen say that the giant...
that are most precious to you.
Northmen tell how the gods punished Loki for Baldur's death. They captured him and took him to a cave. They fetched his two sons and turned one into a wolf, and he ripped his brother apart. The gods used Loki's own son's entrails to tie him down and turned these bonds to iron and dangled a poisonous serpent over his face so that its venom would drip onto him. Each time the venom drips onto Loki's face, he writhes in agony. The Northmen say that is the cause of earthquakes. A reminder, perhaps.
You can't read this language. You don't understand.
Sinbad was right.
You're wasting time.
You're cursed.
You'll succeed.
Slow, quicker.
Dillian never much cared for the underworld and looked dimly upon the druids like her father, Zinbel. I guess he took after his father, a chieftain who believed nothing he couldn't see, and he happened to be blind. She felt safe in Dillian's arms, had to see the world through his eyes. Slowly, the darkness that had bound her so tightly began to unravel.
Senua, your father cannot understand your darkness. He cannot see through your eyes. No one can. My own father was born blind. Doesn't have the faintest idea of what the night looks like. The word dark to him means as little as the word light. So someone is afraid of the dark. Should we fix them by taking away their sight? Would you give up the beautiful world that you, and only you, can see just to be rid of your nightmares? Or is this the price you pay for the gift you have? gift that makes you so special in my eyes. Just another part of the person I know.
I left for the wilds to protect you from my darkness. Because I love you. But it made it worse. I'm so sorry.
Killing you would be too easy.
They're taking your memories to torture you.
They're taking you from the inside.
You're disappearing one memory at a time. Every time you remember.